Adam is my youngest son. When he passed away, he was 21 years and a half. Volunteered in the fire department in Goochland, I think since he was 16 or 17, as soon as he was allowed to. He's a good kid. He had a bad shoulder injury for which he had even surgery. And I suspect that progressed into prescription medication, progressed to heroin. On that day, we had a long conversation. I remember at least about an hour, maybe 2 hours. And we went to the bookstore to buy him books for his class. It's been about half hour looking through books and talking. And then after that, just right by the traffic light by the nursing school, he has to go to the parking garage, and I have to go to my office and give me a hug, and I give him a hug. And that's kind of the signature. I haven't gone to the bookstore since.
There will probably be 50 or 60,000 people in this country that die this year from opiate overdoses. We've never done a very good job of helping healthcare providers learn how to most effectively prescribe opiates. And with the opiate crisis that's going on, we've realized the need to be able to provide people some really expert guidance on how best to prescribe opiates.
After you lose somebody dear to you, you're just like, you're off balance. Accidentally going through the university website, somebody pointed out, well, you know, they have a program about addiction. So I looked into it closer. The more I looked at it, the more I wanted to enroll and know more.
What we try to do is make it really useful for the people that are taking the course to really apply to their practice. This is such a big crisis that we're actually going to do something new to try to regulate providers to be able to address this, and that's adding continuing education requirements that are specific around opiates.
My goal was, once I'm going through it and learning, is that how many people like me who went through life not knowing the stuff, and I figured that I identified my role to be in what I do and use that as an educator, teach residents, students, nurses, because there's a need for learning more about the disease, so that's what I do.
I think one of the things that I'm most proud about VCU and VCU Health is that we see ourselves as trying to enrich our broader community. Anywhere in the world, someone could take this if they've got internet access. And so part of what we're trying to do is say, look, if you need help with this issue and how to prescribe more safely, we want to help you, because that's part of our mission at VCU.
To some degree, it's a therapy for me, meaning that it allows me to understand what my son went through. The second part is that I hope, everything that I do would save one father from going what I went through, it'd be worth it.